discussing about a topic of English which is clause, and then we are going to discuss the type of clause which is adverb clause. Now, first coming to the definition of clause. Now, clause is basically a group of words which are joined together. They consist of subject and predicate of their own, and they also contain a verb within those collection of words. So if these three criteria in the collection of words is met, then we say that a collection of word is referred to as clause. The conditions are that it should contain a subject of its own, it should consider a predicate of its own, and it must contain a verb within it. And if the collection of words in those collection, if these three criteria are met, then we consider that collection to be a clause. Now, there are different type of clauses, such as noun subordinate clause, adjective subordinate clause, and adverb subordinate clause. And out of all these three, today we are going to cover the adverb subordinate clause. Now, as the name suggests, adverb clause, it means that the clause will contain an adverb of its own, and when it contains an adverb of its own, it is important that it should have a subject and a predicate of its own. So, how can we define an adverb subordinate clause? The definition will be, those collection of words that contain an adverb or they can also act as an adverb, then I can say they contain a subject and a predicate of their own, they are referred to as adverb subordinate clause. They are referred to as adverb subordinate clause. Now, when I say they rested at sunset, when I'm saying they rested at sunset over here will be underlined, and out of that we have to select the clause. But at sunset, I say I cannot see a subject or a predicate, right? I can only see an adverb which is at and nothing else. Now, my collection of words does not contain a subject or a predicate. Then, that collection of words is referred to as a phrase. Therefore, at sunset is not a clause and it is a phrase. So, remember that there is only a fine line between a phrase and a clause, and that fine line is just the definition that in that collection, we need to make sure that there is a subject and a predicate. If both of these or either of these is missing, then that collection becomes a phrase. So therefore, this is my phrase and not my clause. And because at is an adverb, therefore it is referred to as an adverb phrase and not a clause. Why? Because my verb rested is modified. How it is modified? As I say that when did they rest? My question over here is when? That when did they rest? I get the answer at sunset. So my rest over here is modified. Therefore, my collection of word is a phrase and it is an adverb phrase because it contains an adverb within it. It acts as an adverb. Now, in second example, I say they rested when evening came. Now sunset means that evening is coming, and sunrise means that it is about to get morning, right? Now rested when evening came. Here when is my subject and evening came is my predicate. Now my collection of words has a subject and a predicate, therefore this becomes my adverb clause. Why does it become my adverb clause? Because all the criteria of becoming a clause is satisfied in this collection, and I say that my verb rested is modified, therefore it is my adverb clause and not adverb phrase. So these are the two differences between adverb phrase and adverb clause. Now in this video we will also be studying that adverb clause can be further categorized depending upon different criteria. So next, now we are going to study the categories of adverb clause. So now let us discuss different type of adverb clause. So types can be, first is it can be considered as adverb clause of time. Next it can be adverb clause of condition. Then third can be adverb clause of place. Then next can be adverb clause of result. Fifth can be adverb clause of purpose. It can also be adverb clause of reason. So these are the some classification of adverb clause. Adverb clause of time, adverb clause of condition, adverb clause of place, adverb clause of result, adverb clause of purpose, and adverb clause of reason. So first we are going to study about adverb clause of time. Now we know that all those clauses which symbolizes time or which represents the time at which something is occurring, then we consider that clause to be the adverb clause of time. So in these clause there are conjunctions, and those conjunctions can be, in time there are conjunctions. Those conjunctions can be, now time is represented by the question when. So first conjunction will be when. It can also be whenever, or as soon as, or before, after, till, until, since, for. So these are some of the examples of the conjunctions which can be used to describe time. Now example can be like, the interval occurs after half movie is over. The interval occurs after half movie is over is my clause. Half movie is the subject and is over is the predicate. So the interval occurs after half movie is over. This is my adverb clause, and this is the adverb clause of time because here a time is being represented. Another example can be, we go for a movie whenever my cousins visit us. We go for a movie whenever my cousins visit us. This is again a clause because it contains a subject, a predicate and a verb as well. Here also it contains a subject, a predicate and over is again referred to as a verb. So in these we know that are clauses and they represent the time. Therefore first we have understood the adverb clause of time. Next we are going to study about the adverb clause of condition. Now let us discuss the second type of adverb clause, which is adverb clause of condition. So now second we are talking about adverb clause of condition. Now there are three type of conditional clause. The three type of conditional clause include, the first conditional clause is present likely. Present likely will always contain present indefinite and they will contain the modal such as will or shall. So first is present likely. It will contain present indefinite and it will also contain will or shall. Like I can say that if you run fast, you will reach there on time. If you run fast, you will reach there on time. Present likely, some condition is likely to happen, and then a present indefinite which contains either will or shall. Or another example can be, if you work hard, you shall succeed. Now, if you work hard, you shall succeed. Work hard is again, if you work hard, it is present likely, again a condition. Then you shall succeed, shall. And this is indefinite, that we do not know the exact time when you will succeed. So this is present indefinite with shall. Now next, if I talk about next type of condition, which is present unlikely. Next is present unlikely. Here it will contain a subjunctive mood and instead of will or shall we will be making use of would or could. Here present unlikely also represents some kind of regret or wish, right? It represents some kind of regret or wish. Example can be, remember that these are all the clause of condition. Condition always starts with if. I can say, if I was rich, I would help you. If I were rich, I would help you. Another example can be, they came if they come I could give them gifts again. Now this is a regret that they have not come, therefore I was not able to give gifts to them. Then if I were rich, I would help you. Again, this is a wish that if I was rich, then maybe I would have helped you. So this is again present unlikely. It represents some kind of regret or a wish, and it is used with would or could. Here I'm using would, and in this sentence I'm making use of the modal could. Now the third condition of adverb of condition is the past condition. The third condition is the past condition. The past condition is always in a past perfect form. And we know that past perfect form always has some kind of modal plus have. So here I can say could, would, might, plus have, because have is used to represent my perfect tense. Now example of such conditions can be, first is if she had written the letter, she would have got reply yesterday. If she had written the letter, would have got the reply yesterday, and if she had written, it as a past condition, so completely fits on this condition. Next example can be if he had brought money, he could have enjoyed the picnic. So here I'm making use of could have, here I'm making use of would have. So these are the two examples of my past condition. So here we have studied about adverb clause of condition. There were three conditions. First was the present definite, second was the indefinite, and third I'm talking about the past condition. Now next we are going to understand the type of adverb, which is the adverb of place. So adverb clause of place is the third type of adverb clause. Now adverb clause of place contains conjunctions such as where or wherever. So third is my adverb clause of place. Now my adverb clause of place will contain conjunctions such as where or wherever. Now another important point is that it must qualify the place that we are mentioning in main clause. So if these two conditions are met, then we call that clause as the adverb clause of place. First is that it should contain the conjunction such as where or wherever, and second is that it must qualify the place in the main clause. Example of this can be, I will go to Delhi where my father lives. Now when I am saying I will go to Delhi where my father lives, again it is introduced by a conjunction where, which represents the place, and Delhi over here is the place, right? It is qualifying the noun, right? this becomes my adjective clause. So I will go to Delhi where my father lives. Then this clause fixes the situation because it is qualifying the place in the main noun and it is also making use of where. Another example is, I do not know where I have to go. Again, where is there in the sentence, therefore it is the adverb clause of place. Third example can be, I shall follow you wherever you may go. Now, I shall follow you wherever you may go. Again, wherever is being used and you may go is my adverb clause. Because you go can also be right, but again I'm making use of may as an adverb. So this is my adverb clause. Now here we have discussed the third type of clause, adverb clause, which is adverb clause of place. Next we are going to discuss the adverb clause of result. So next over here we will be discussing adverb clause of result. Adverb clause of result is represented by that as the adverb clause. It is represented by that as the adverb clause. And then it is preceded by so. It is preceded by so or that. Sorry, so or such. So that or such that. Examples can be, he was so late that he could not watch the entire movie. He was so late that. So the result of coming late is that he could not watch the entire movie. So again, this is an adverb clause of result. That result is being announced because of the reason of getting late. Another example can be, he is such an intelligent boy that he can easily pass an exam. Again, such that. Now, the result of being intelligent is that he can easily pass in the exam. The result of being late is that he could not watch the entire movie. So now this adverb of clause defines the result of something which is occurring. So here we have talked about adverb clause of result. Now next we will be discussing the adverb clause of purpose. Adverb clause of purpose Now in adverb clause of purpose we make use of conjunctions. Those conjunctions are that, so that, in order, that, lest, etc. So whenever these conjunctions are used with the adverb clause, then that clause becomes the adverb clause of purpose. Example is that he went to Delhi so that he can meet his father. Now, so that, again, there is a purpose behind going to Delhi. And what is that purpose? So that he can meet his father. Another example to show some kind of purpose is that you should work hard in order that you might pass. Now again, you should work hard. Why? Again, there's a purpose for working hard, because we need to pass. So, in order that you might pass. So, this is again showing some kind of purpose. So, here we have completed the last adverb clause of purpose, and we've also discussed the examples. In this video, we have basically focused on the adverb clause. We have discussed how to differentiate an adverb phrase with adverb clause. And then we also discuss the different types or different classification of adverb clause, and we've implemented different examples of each type to understand each of that classification in a clear manner.